Welcome to another video on the C programming video series for the beginners. In this video, we will talk about signed and unsigned integers in C language. In the previous tutorials, we have seen how we can create an integer variable, how we can store value in that, and how we can display the value. For example, here I have created an integer variable called as number. I have stored value 30 in this variable, and then we are using this printf function in order to display the value of this number variable. Now here the variable number can contain positive number, negative number or zero. For example, if I save this program and if I run this, nothing special happens. We get number is 30 as the output. Now, as I said before, this variable can contain a negative number also. For example, if I make it negative 130, minus 130, if I save and run this program, we will get minus 130 here. And similarly, this variable can contain the value of 0. Now, in one of the previous tutorial about size of, we have seen that in our computer, for storing the integer variables, 4 bytes of memory is used. And because of that, the values that can be stored in this variable will be from this number to this number. Now, since this number variable is of type integer, and in order to store integer values, my computer uses 4 bytes, which we have seen in the previous tutorial, the value range will be from this negative number to this positive number. So what it means is this variable can contain any value between this value to this value. Now, since this variable can contain the positive number, negative number and zero, this variable is a signed integer variable. Now, there will be some cases where as a programmer, we know that the value that we are going to store in the variable will be either zero or a positive number. It will not be a negative number. For example, let us say in our program, we have a variable. Let us call it as number of subscribers. Now, we know that this number of subscribers can be zero or a positive number. It will not be a negative number. There is no way this channel can have a negative number of subscribers. It will be either zero or a positive number. So if I want to store this number of subscribers in this number of subscribers variable, then I know that the value can be either zero or a positive number. It will not be a negative number. As a programmer, while writing this code, we can mention that this variable will not contain a negative number. So in order to do that, we use a keyword called as unsigned. While defining the variable, we use the keyword unsigned before the data type. So here with this definition, we are stating that this variable will not contain negative value. The value will be zero or a positive number. Now, after that, we can use this variable as a normal variable. And in order to display the value present in this variable using the printf function, we have to use the format specifier %u. So here I will say number of subscribers and then the format specifier %u. Now here I will refer the number of subscribers variable. Now if I save this program, and before running this, I will change the value to 100. If I save this program and if I run this now, we get number of subscribers 100. Now here, as a programmer, we are stating that this variable will not contain a negative value. Now, if you look at the difference between this number variable and number of subscribers variable, then while defining this number of subscribers variable, before the data type, we have mentioned the keyword unsigned. Now, with this number variable, before the data type, we don't have any keyword. Actually, here we can use the keyword signed. If we don't use this signed, the C language by default will treat this integer variable as a signed variable. So if you want to create a signed variable, then you don't have to specify this signed keyword. By default, the C language will automatically consider that. But if you want to store unsigned values, then you have to mention that by using this unsigned keyword. Now, what is the advantage of using this unsigned variables? Now, if we look at this signed integer variable called as number here, the value range is from this negative value to this positive value. But if you mention that this variable will contain unsigned value, then remember, for integer types, 4 bytes of memory is used in my computer, and there will not be any negative numbers. So the value range increases. So now, since this number of subscribers variable will not contain negative value, the value range will be from 0 to this number. Now, when we mention this signed and unsigned keywords, they are called as sign modifiers. We can use this signed and unsigned keyword with integer data type and also with the character data type. Why? In the previous tutorial about the character variable, we have seen that according to the encoding standard used, some numeric value is stored in that variable, which will represent a particular character. For example, if I have this variable letter, and if I store this capital A in this letter variable, then a numeric value according to the encoding standard is stored in this letter variable. And since internally numeric value is stored, we can make this character variables signed or unsigned. For example, we can have unsigned char num. Now, in this num variable, we can store a value from 0 to 255, assuming that for a character variable, 1 byte of memory is used. Now, one more thing that I want to talk about here is, now when we have a character variable without mentioning the signed or unsigned keyword, for example, like the way I have mentioned here, the default behavior of this char variable is implementation defined. So we can't really surely say that, you know, it will be signed or unsigned. It will depend on the implementation. If you want to make a character variable signed or unsigned, then it's better you mention that. For example, signed char num1, unsigned char num2, something like this. So here we use this signed and unsigned keyword in C programming language in order to state whether a variable will contain negative value or not. If the variable is a signed variable, it means that the variable can contain the positive number, negative number, and zero. If the variable is unsigned, then it can store zero or a positive number. With the integers, when we don't specify whether it is signed or unsigned, the default is signed, which means the variable can contain positive number and negative number. If you want to make the variable unsigned, then you have to mention that, like the way I have done here. With the character data type, we can also make the character variables signed or unsigned. All we have to do is use this keyword signed or unsigned. And when we define the character variable without using the signed or unsigned keyword, the default behavior will be implementation dependent. And that's why if you want to store signed values or unsigned values in a character variable, then you should mention that by using the signed and unsigned keyword, like the way I have done here. And also, it is very important, when you have an unsigned variable, you should not try to store a negative value in that. If you try to do that, then the behavior of your program will not be predictable. Now, just to demonstrate this, what I'm going to do is I will modify this value, which is stored in this number of subscribers integer variable. So I will make it as -100. And after that, what I will do is I will add a value of 10 to the value present in this number of subscribers variable. So I will write number of subscribers equal to number of subscribers plus 10. So all I am doing here is I have stored a negative value in a variable which is defined as unsigned, and then I have tried to add a value of 10 to the value which is already present in this number of subscribers variable, and then I am storing that result back in this number of subscribers variable. And here we are displaying the value using the printf function, and we are using the format specifier %u. And now if I save this program and if I run this, now if you look at the result here, my expectation is the value should be -90, but the value that we get here in the output is a different number. Now why we get this number here, we can discuss about that, but in this video series for a beginner, I think that topic is a bit difficult at this particular moment, but we will talk about that in some other video. So always make sure that when you have an unsigned variable, you should not store a negative value in that. So this is it guys for this particular video. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. If you have anything to say, write that in the comment box. For more tutorials, subscribe to the channel.